read that homeopathy has been characterised within the scientific and medical communities as nonsense, quackery, and a sham. That crucial information doesn't appear by accident. It's the work of a group called Guerrilla Skeptics on Wikipedia, founded and led by our next speaker, Susan Gerbic. The mission of the Guerrilla Skeptics on Wikipedia is to improve the content of skepticism-related articles and to hold any claims on paranormal-themed pages to account. In 2012, Susan won the Skeptics Toolbox in the Trenches Award for her work as a skeptical leader and change maker in taking on what she says can seem like an insurmountable world of woo. In 2013, she was the recipient of the James Randi Award for Skepticism in the Public Interest. Susan Gerbic's degree is in social history. She's a professional portrait photographer, a skeptical activist, and a self-described Wikipediatrician. She loves people, especially if they're under five. And we share a passion for hats. Raised in California as a Southern Baptist, when Susan discovered the skeptical community, she says, "I felt like I had found my people." We are your people, Susan. And we're fascinated to hear more about guerrilla skepticism on Wikipedia. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to Australia and to the stage, Susan Gerbic.
The GSoW project is just 4 years old. And we're all over the world. We're a volunteer group of people that are all over the world that meet on a private forum. And we discuss, we train, we socialize, we brainstorm on how it's best to write or improve Wikipedia pages. And we're mostly concerned with pages concerning scientific skepticism. And we're also doing this work in all languages we possibly can. Apparently, push the button. There you go. Art done by the same person who did the cartoon that you just saw. We strongly believe that in order to educate, we need content. We fully understand that it's imperative that people are taught how to think about things, obviously. And, you know, we know that schools and parents and different places, you know, YouTube and things like that, are trying to do that. They're trying to teach people how to think. So we're kind of the other side of the coin. Once they are coming to a realization that they need to have some information about a topic, they're more likely to go to an internet search. One of the first topics they're going to get is they're going to get a Wikipedia link. They're going to go to the Wikipedia page, and they're going to probably only read the lead, which is the very top part of it. We're hoping they'll read the whole thing, but if all they get is the lead, they're going to get some information from there. It is extremely important that Wikipedia is in great shape, because most people end up going to Wikipedia. That's kind of where it is. Anybody out there used Wikipedia lately? Hands up. Okay, how many used it today? Anybody check out the speakers that are going to be presenting in the next few days? Yeah, okay. So a lot of those people we have written, we have our hands in just about everything, and we need to have our hands in a lot more. So I shouldn't have to tell you how influential Wikipedia is to the government, to the media, to schools, and to just everyday life. I mean, I'm sure you already know that. But what we're trying to do is we're trying to make sure that we're getting really great content in a place people will find it that is free and accessible. And I should let you know that Wikipedia is the 10th most viewed website in the world. Hands down, 10th most. So I'm going to pull up some examples. And this is just some work that my team has done, Australian focused. So there's a lot more content out there that we have done that is non-Australian focused. I mean, I had a limited amount of time, so I couldn't sit here and show you everything. There's going to be a lot of words on these slides. I do not want you reading them. I can tell if you're reading, I can see your eyes. But I don't want you reading them, because I know that's what happens. Text goes up and your brain forces you to read the text. What I've done is I put out a blog that is there now that has, like, the show notes. It has all the information of all the pages that I'm going to show you on these slides, and it has some more information as well. And it'll have even more, because it'll show you, like, the before, when we got involved with the page, and then the after. So there's a lot you can look at during the breaks today look at. But I have that. It's all sitting there waiting for you now. Don't look in, but you will be able to look really eyes up front. So you're going to be able to look at that really soon. Oh, and imagine I have my Tasmanian hat on because I forgot it. It's Coach, just pretend it's there. So before I start showing these slides, I just want to introduce a few people that are here today as representatives of the GSoW project. And I just want to point them out to you so that you guys can see who they are and ask questions, because I am totally here at your calling. So I am more than happy to spend hours with you sitting down talking about Wikipedia and activism and psychics. We call them grief vampires. So over here, you're going to find Monica. There's her hand up. She's on our Spanish team. She also does some things in English. Svetlana, there she is right over here. She runs my Russian team and the massive Russian team that I have. Michelle Franklin, who's sitting in her hammock right now watching this. Hi, Michelle. If she were here, she's in Humpty Doo up in Darwin. And she has done one of the big projects that I'm going to show you in a minute. And then Greg Nelson, who's right over here. Say hey, Greg. Greg has he's just done some amazing things. There's an audio interview I did with him for Skepticality, and also on our YouTube channel, and you'll be able to hear him on there and explain the project. But almost a lot of this work that you're going to see up above is a lot of it's Greg's, because Greg is very focused on Australia, and he's also focused on astronomy, so that just kind of fits in really well together. So a lot of it's up there. So before I show you these slides, I just want to note that GSoW is not the only people out there doing work on Wikipedia. There are thousands of editors out there working on Wikipedia and robots. They call them bots, B-O-T. And they're going through anonymously improving Wikipedia pages, taking off the crap off of there that shouldn't be there. And so we're not the only ones. We're just public. We are really, if you didn't know us any differently, you would know that we're just regular Wikipedia editors. We just train differently, we have a community, and it just makes us a little bit different. We have a different kind of way of doing things. So I'm going to show you these slides, and I don't want to take up a lot of time showing the slides. So like I said, you'll be able to go to the blog, and you'll be able to get the better, in detail, you'll be able to look at these pages. So here's one of the first pages I'm going to show you. This is Amanda Bauer, and this is a page that Greg created, I believe, from scratch. And she's an astronomer, and she's an Australian astronomer. There she is again. This is Bart Bock, who is a Dutch astronomer. And you guys are going to be able to learn all about this whenever you get to it. We have a lead. The very top part of each Wikipedia page is the lead. And this has got a little more detail right up here. This is what we suspect that most people are only going to be able to read, is the lead, the minimal lead. They're just really interested in just that small portion of the page, most people. Now, Bart Bock is associated with Canberra because of some work he did in Canberra back in the 60s and 70s. You might not know who he is, but he's an amazing person. And his wife was also an astronomer. And Monica over here, she translated the page from English over into Spanish. Amazing. And here is Patricia Bock, who is the wife of Bart Bach, and Bart Bach is the husband of Patricia Bach. They're both amazing people. And Patricia and Bart, when you read the Wikipedia pages, I feel like a bit of a love story, kind of in between the lines. You read through it. We're trying to make pages that are readable, interesting, not gossipy or anything like that, but we want to tell the person's story and as best as we can so that people are able to want to read the entire page. We don't want it to be like a CV or resume or something like that. That's just how boring that is. So when you go and you read about Bart and Priscilla, I think that in between the lines you're going to see that it is a love story of two people who felt a passion towards astronomy. This is a page you might know. Over there. You might know Maynard. So this is a page that Greg created to finish his training process. Part of our training is that you have to rewrite a page. So when I asked Greg, I gave him probably 10 places, and I said, which one do you want? He said, Maynard, mine, this, stand up, everybody else. So he completely recreated this page for Maynard, because we feel that it's important that when people are in the news, that they have to have a really well-written Wikipedia page. Even if they're not in the news, they need to have these Wikipedia pages, because they represent us. Even if you don't like the person, well, we all love Maynard. But even still, you have to have their backs, because they are us. The world sees them as the skeptic community. What the heck is that? So we have to make sure we have these people's pages. Here's another really great one. I'm sure you've met Dr. Rachey or heard of Dr. Rachey a lot. One of my editors, Sean Wickham, created this page. And as she becomes more notable, and she's in the news more often, and so on, people are going to Google her name. So it's real important that there's something for them to see that shows this woman is notable. She's freaking awesome. In fact, I talked to a woman yesterday at dinner, and she was telling me that she kind of got into skepticism. She was into the science stuff, but she got into skepticism, and she happened to hear Rachel Dunlap on a radio program that had nothing to do with skepticism. And then she Googled her, and she was like, wow, this woman is kind of interesting, you know. I didn't ask her if she got to the Wikipedia page or not, because I think it was before we created this page. But you don't know how these people are going to touch our lives in some way. Okay, this next page, I want a nice big blue for whenever I pull it up. This is a project that we had done. We spent about 6 months working on vaccines. Everything has to do with vaccines, pro and con. This is Stephanie. Oh. So I felt so important. Because I'm heavily influenced by what's reported on in the Skeptic Zone. I'm in California, so, you know. So whenever he was constantly reporting on what was going on with the Sherry Tenpenny, Stephanie Messenger, anti-vax, when I was looking for a project for my entire team to take on, I went and said, well, maybe we should do vaccines. So a lot of things we've done are vaccine related. They're not all on the slideshow that I have right now because there's so many. But Stephanie Messenger is one I wrote because I felt that it was important to try to find out what is her reasoning. Why is she so anti-vax? What is going on here? Because I think understanding their reasoning helps. Plus also if Stephanie Messenger is in the media again for whatever reason, I know the media is going to pick up on her Wikipedia page, and they're going to be able to get a lot more information about her that really should be out there. Again, it's all citable, no gossip, nothing like that. Here is the page that she created, Melanie's Marvelous Measles. Right. So Melanie's Marvelous Measles, since I was already writing the Stephanie Messenger page, I was able to write the Melanie's Marvelous Measles. I learned a ton about this page, and you will too whenever you read it. There's some really interesting links towards a lot of other things. I'm not going to tell you because I don't want to ruin the surprise. I kind of started with Sherry Tenpenny.
Shame!
I love you guys. Okay, Sherry Tenpenny had already had a Wikipedia page. I just went through and I added this planned tour to Australia and the cancellations. I was able to quote a lot of you people that were creating content, which was fantastic. Here's another page that Greg did, Warwick Couch, another amazing man. I had no idea who these people are, and they didn't have pages. It's just, you're reading this, and when Greg was putting this up, and he's working on it, we work on it, kind of as teams, you know, it depends on how you want to do it, but we put it up in a place where you can't see it, the general public. And we're just talking back and forth on a forum about it, looking for more citations, changing, you know, words, saying a sentence is confusing, rewriting it, things like that. So when this page came up, I'd never heard of him. I looked at this and I said, oh my gosh, this guy has done freaking everything but Dancing with the Stars. So, you know, I think maybe we should come up with some kind of Dancing with the Stars with astronomers. Just astronomers, right? All these people dancing. Anyway, so I think it'd be brilliant. Whoever's out there who can take care of it, I want the credit for it, but I please do it. Here's another astronomer, astronomer William Bradfield, that Greg created. Another very amazing person that didn't have a Wikipedia page, I believe. And Greg's also went through and has taken care of a few other pages, the Astronomical Society of Victoria. He's also written the Wikipedia page for the Astronomical Society of New South Wales, because it's very important that these people have well-written pages, if they deserve it, and they do. Somebody needs to care enough to put these together. Okay, now, so we're gonna pause for just a half a second, and remember, Michelle's over there in her hammock. Hey, Michelle. And Humpty Doo. And her final training project was a page. It took her forever to pick up a page to work on for her final project, and she was in training for a year. I have people who go through training in weeks or days, and I have people who take a year or more. And you know, I train at whatever pace for people go through, and I do the training. So I told Michelle, let's do this one together. We'll do the Australian Skeptics page. I'm sure it's in really good shape. And it took us months. And she was amazing. She's still probably from her hammock over there writing and filling this in. But when you get a chance, you got to look at the Australian Skeptic page. We completely rewrote it. It's still a work in progress. And there's a lot of things to change. One of the things we noticed is it goes on forever, because you guys are freaking awesome. There is so much stuff that you guys have done. But you don't have individual Wikipedia pages. Each group doesn't have their own Wikipedia page. And the ones that are noteworthy are going to end up getting a Wikipedia page, trust me. But as we can do that, we can shrink this page, the Australian Skeptics page, we can shrink it, because instead of putting a lot of information about each individual group or the awards you've given, it will just simply be a link and somebody can go to it and get more information from there. So the Australian Skeptics page is, again, like I say, it has been completely rewritten. Only in the last couple weeks has this page been finished, and we're still not done with it. And anybody can edit it. I mean, it's not just GSoW you can do it. Anybody can edit Wikipedia. While I was in on my tour, because I've been in Australia for a couple weeks, I've been all over Melbourne, Mordialloc, Tasmania, Canberra, Sydney, Brisbane, and then after this I go to Hong Kong, and then I'm going to lecture there a couple times, and then in China, and then go back to San Francisco area, which is kind of where I'm from. But while I was there, I did some hands-on workshops, and I'm happy to work with anybody who wants any hands-on instruction. And one of the groups I worked with was in Tasmania, and it's called the Launceston Skeptics. And I hope you should pronounce that right, because I practice a lot to be able to pronounce that. I was saying Launceston. That's how we pronounce everything in Spanish, where I live, because everything's in Spanish. So it's the Launceston Skeptics, and they're so well organized. If you haven't met them yet, you'll have to look at their Wikipedia page that just was created a couple days ago. I was able to do this out of my hotel. It took me maybe 4 or 5 hours, and I loved every minute of it. Jin Ho and the other Australians, Launceston Skeptics, have their citations, all the media that they've done on their website, and they're just really well organized. It's just so, it's like so simple to put the Wikipedia page together in their case, because I didn't have to chase anything down and do a lot of research. It was already done. And then Jin Ho knew how to upload pictures for Wikimedia, because the workshop we had done at in his little area, we were able to go through and upload pictures, because I did hands-on training with them. So this is a little closer. You guys will really love this. And make sure you're following the links and so on. We also created the Friends of Science and Medicine page. Gosh, ages ago it feels like. And this was a fascinating group. We love to work on pages of projects, events, things like that. I think that's really important. And I haven't met this woman yet. I ran into the stairway yesterday, but you know, I hurt when you ran into Gerbic. I didn't actually talk to her. I don't know. This is Loretta. Loretta Bren? Moran? You guys are totally familiar, okay? So I've heard her talked about on Skeptic Zone many times, and, you know, there was no Wikipedia page for her. Can you believe it? There was no Wikipedia page for this woman? I'm reading this thing, and proofreading it, and going through it, and my jaw is dropping as Greg is writing this. I'm thinking, how could this person not have a Wikipedia page? This is freaking ridiculous. This person is amazing. I was just really, really impressed with her. And we have a lot in common. We both had breast cancer, and mine was just really recently. And it was just fascinating to read about her. Just, you guys have got to read these pages all the way through and follow all the other links. And lastly, I'm going to show you, I have one more thing to tell you about this page. So I don't know if you guys realize it, but Wikipedia has a front page of Wikipedia that if you go to, you know, wikipedia.org, whatever, there is a lot of content on there that's on there for about 12 hours. They have like a section called What's in the News Right Now, Wikipedia page of the day, a photo of the day, kind of thing like that. Well, one of the sections on there is called Did You Know? ? And Tim Marley kind of gave me the idea to edit Wikipedia for skeptical content because it's very powerful. Tim Farley did give me, say that we should be trying to get things on Did You Know? Because when you're on Did You Know, it's only like maybe six different people could be on there, six different Wikipedia pages, and it's tight. It's really hard to get on. There's a lot of paperwork involved. Only the best pages get to be on the Did You Know? But when it's there, it's like getting outside of our choir, which is what we're about, right? Education. We're trying to get people interested in our community, interested in our people, our books, our podcasts, our magazines, our organizations, our conferences. By getting on the Did You Know, then anybody who looks at the front page of Wikipedia and clicks on that link is going to learn about somebody that they probably didn't know of before. So Greg created this page just, a week or so ago, I think this has only been live. And he applied for all the paperwork, and we've been like rushing it through to try to get it to, we were gonna try to get it, Did You Know, today, but it turns out it's gonna be tomorrow. So one of the things I need you to do is, you can read it today, but tomorrow for sure, we need you to go and just go and look at the page. Just click on the link, so that what will happen is it'll bring the stats up, and that's real important for the stats to just go shoom in one day. And it can be anywhere from, you know, we get the results maybe 1,000 people will look at the page, or maybe it'll be 15 or 20,000 people will look at the page. We don't know. So if you push it on your social media and say, and tell your family and friends, hey, go read this page today. It'll should be up at noon tomorrow, and we'll remind you again, and it'll be up for 12 hours. So we really would like your help to try to get this page kind of pushed up in the stats, because it's just a one way of us focusing on one page everybody learns about. And then lastly, long time ago, we created a Wikipedia page for the young Australian skeptics. You might get a kick at looking at this page. So I think I'm going to have time for questions here. I'm almost done. If I go over here, oh, there's a close-up here. Oh, I don't have one. Woo! There's another one that I was highly influenced on with Skeptic Zone. I'm following what's going on in Northern Rivers vaccination supporters. Oh my gosh, what amazing people. They've just been in existence maybe a year, and I said, I wonder if we can create a Wikipedia page for them. Is there noteworthy information? And sure enough, there was, because they've been on the news, and so they're notable enough. So one of my editors in Britain, because we're a worldwide organization, he created this Wikipedia page, and we sprang it on him at a Brisbane skeptic in the camp. They didn't know that we were creating a page for them. And you'll be able to see this on the blog when we go to that later in the show notes that I gave you. But they were totally surprised that we were creating this Wikipedia page for them. And I think with Heidi, who was in the audience, and somebody was filming her as it came up on the screen on a, that we put together, and she's like, what? And then they said, come on up here, and she's like, okay. Then she sent me a Facebook message about an hour or two later. She goes, I just think it's just now hitting me that this happened. Thank you so much. And it is. It's a blast. We only make pages for people who are noteworthy. But there's a lot of people out there who need it. It's just we can't get to them. We need people. So let's see if I... okay, well, whatever. So we're going to freeze them. Quit reading it. All right? Just concentrate. Eyes over here again. So as you can see, Language, distance, culture, that can't divide us. We are a community. I've been to a lot of conferences, and I love conferences. This is my, I think that skeptics in the camp, skeptics in the pub, skeptic camps, all those kind of conferences, things, these are like the first step of activism for most people. Because you're making contact with somebody else. You're taking that step out from behind your computer and your podcast, and you're actually taking a little bit of venture out there into maybe a world that's a little scary because you don't know anybody. But that's okay, because we all want to know you. Well, some of you. But, we have a common goal. We're trying to educate, right? That's the whole goal. So we want to educate people. We want to help people learn how to think. We want to help people learn how to be better skeptics, thinking about things in their lives. And this has made... technology has made us a lot better. Technology has improved a lot of things, but we're always back to the same problem. And the problem, in my view, is it's our people, right? I know it feels like the problems in the world today are our laws, the schools, the churches, how people parent, and so on and on, and poverty, and on and on. But I really believe that all these are obstacles that we can overcome. We just have to find the right people. We have to find people that are going to lead us. We need people who are going to train us. People who are going to continue doing all the investigations and publishing, videos, podcasting, and so on. We need those people to continue doing that so we have something to cite as far as Wikipedia goes. We need people to finance us to in order to help make more things happen, to help come up with, you know, financial help with our podcasts and so on. We need people behind the scenes that really make these things happen. We need people, we need to find these people. We need to train them. We need to motivate them. We need to continue motivating. We need to support them. And so I need your help. I mean, we all need your help. Whether or not you want to join the GSoW team, which is, of course, what I would like to have you do, but it is a commitment. It's not something that you enter into lightly. I do all the training. It takes a long time. When you're done, you're with me for years. This is a community of people that you will learn to know. So if you cannot join the GSoW team, that's fine. We understand that it's not for everybody. Please help support someone else. Write reviews for the books that you enjoy on Amazon. Write comments on blogs. Oh my gosh, we love that. Share them. Go to iTunes. If there's a podcast you like or you love, please go and put a comment on iTunes. That brings the ratings up. It gets people out. It makes them continue doing the things they're doing because people aren't paid for a lot of the work that we're doing. These people who are writing books, they're not getting rich off of this. Buy their books. Review their books. Share their books. Share this kind of stuff. So support can mean whatever you want it to mean. But we want you to support us because we need you to have our backs. And we need to have your backs. I don't know what it is that you guys are capable of doing, but I'm sure that you're capable of doing amazing things if you just had the right motivation, the right connections. We helped you find the time. We want more people involved in our community. We need this. We're tiny. We're a little tiny blip of, you know, a little group of people. We got to stop bickering and complaining and drama blogging about each other. We need to just unify and become... just, you know, okay, don't look like it. So please support those people who are doing it for you. When you go to a meetup, buy a drink for the organizer. Thank them. You know, buy them a meal once in a while. Slip them a $5 note or something. Just, you know, be there for them. And have them back and tell them thank you. Give them feedback. Offer to staple things for them or something. I don't know. But whatever support level that you're comfortable doing, micropayments or whatever, please do it. We need you. So our people are our most important tool and our most important asset, and we need to just know that. Isn't that done?
So we've got the lovely Kate here. Thank you. Hello again, Susan. I just wondered when you created the page for Stephanie Messenger, or was it Greg that created the page? But was there any pushback from Stephanie and other anti-vaxxers?
I get this question a lot, and I'm glad you're specific about it. We are not receiving any pushback from anyone. Absolutely no one. I get that constantly. Where people are saying, oh, you can't create a page for that vax person or whatever. They're always attacked online. And we do a lot of controversial pages. Stephanie Messenger was one. We hear nothing, absolutely nothing, because the page is so well written by our group. I mean, it's seen by, you know, five or six people that are going through it, and we are the worst critics. If there's something on there that doesn't belong on there, we are really, really tight about it. We argue about certain terms and things like that. But Stephanie Messenger, nothing. Absolutely. And so far, we haven't heard from really anybody. The reason partly is because, and I know somebody's going to ask a question about trolls and people coming in and changing the pages. That doesn't happen very often, if at all, anymore, at all. Part of the reason is because Wikipedia has a lot of tight rules. Somebody comes in and tries to change the Wikipedia page, it's changed right back, pretty much, most of the time. And most people who are into the paranormal field, like I'm going to say this kindly, they don't understand the rules, they don't understand evidence, they don't understand how to follow these procedures, they feel persecuted a lot of times, and so they try to change a page and they're almost always, you know, it's changed back and they leave, and they don't come back to Wikipedia. So it's a time that we have, it's a perfect storm right now where Wikipedia is kind of like, we can change this and it'll stay. We just have to get to all those pages to start making the changes. We gotta find all the bad stuff.
I think we've got time for another question, Kate.
Is there a GSoW Wikipedia page?
Thank you. No, there is not. We were just talking about it dinner. We're going to have to write it. It's or somebody's going to have to write it. It's just going to get written. There's a Susan Gerbic page, and it's we wanted to kind of see what would happen when that came out. But it's important that even though I've had people like said, let's make a Wikipedia page for so and so, and they're like, oh no, I don't want a page. It's like, you know what? It's not up to you. It's not for you. Just because your name's on it doesn't mean it's yours. I can't edit my page, but the thing about it is that it represents us as a community, like I say. So if I'm speaking somewhere, if GSoW is speaking somewhere, or any of these other people we've created pages for are in the media, it represents us. So it's not, it is kind of cool to have a page. It's kind of really weird, too. But it's important for the community that we're represented well. So if I'm speaking somewhere or I'm talked to by the media, I do a lot of work with Greek vampires. You can read about that on my Wikipedia page. But if I'm in the media, I need to have my name and mean something. So same with GSoW. We're going to have it mean something so that it's like a cycle, you know. You've got to have the notoriety to get the page, and you get the page, and it brings on more notoriety and sometimes it's plus and not.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please thank Susan?